So nice to see you all here. So first, the topic actually, let me go, dotnet application performance monitoring using Datadog. The same is actually when we perform this for New Relic or Traverse or some other APM. So welcome and introduction to course. So I'm Emil Selim, already presented, a .NET developer with more than 10 years experience. And last 2 years, I'm more focused on application performance management. Why do I choose this topic regarding APM? Today, all work is digital, and we all use internet so massively to work, to study, to research. And from a consumer perspective, we want every website to work fast, to be efficient, to be user-friendly. And from developer perspective, actually, this means that your project needs to work at high performance with low latency and less errors. To achieve this, you need to have a good monitoring system or good application performance management. Most of us here are developers, so we all have projects which have some errors, like this could be UI errors, some database errors, sometimes page is not accessible, sometimes the whole project is not accessible. And you need to have really nice monitoring system to understand what's going on with your system. Why do I prefer to show you a Datadog tool here? First, Datadog is one of the most powerful tools currently in the market. It has easy registration, easy installation and configuration. And only with a few mouse clicks, actually, you can understand what's going wrong. You can see the error rates. You can see what are the top slow database queries. You can create some dashboard. You can generate some monitors alerts. Actually, in general, you don't need to spend like 24 hours to monitor your website. It's made this for you automatically once you configure everything. This will improve actually user experience, will improve the performance of your the entire system. And you don't need to invent the hot water like we say here in Bulgaria. Datadog will not make you, I put a nice image here, like Datadog will not make you a rich person. It will make you a good, better developer, but some people become really rich with this box below, like Dogecoin or Shiba Inu. I'm also mining cryptocurrency, by the way. I need to create a different course for this one. So what is application performance management? It's not complex, it's easy. It's really easy. And how does it work? What is application performance management? Yes, translation of IT metrics into this meaning. Yes, some complex definition, let's go a little more. A practice, yes, a practice to monitor application insight. So we can improve performance generally of the application, improve user experience, can understand actually what's going on with the system, how users are interacting with your application. And is it your application slow response, or maybe this is like reduce issues and errors. Like it is helping you prevent some major incident before happening of your application. Let's, for example, quickly, so you have some store procedures for getting some data, getting properties to the user. And sometimes, normally it works like for 1 second, even like milliseconds to return data. If it starts this slow procedures to be executed, let's see, like 2 seconds, 3 seconds, 4 seconds, and suddenly it could execute like 1 minute, then see, you can predict this, you can catch it before this happening. That's why it's reduced issues and errors. And you have a nice monitoring system, APM generally, let's see, you configure nice monitors and alerts and you receive a notification before this is to happen. Okay, a practice to monitor. What helps to monitor? It helps to monitor front-end. Yes, we all know backend part, JavaScript and some pages, not only like .NET, but any kind of pages, ASPX, MVC, this could be different for the .NET. Again, how, all the code, how services are in interaction with each other. And the infrastructure, this is like monitoring. Imagine, this is not monitoring only your single application, your website, for example. This can be monitored also your servers. Like Windows servers, where an application is located. So you can monitor different like system CPU, memory usage, outage. You know, this information first seems like not that much interesting, like infrastructure, why to monitor the server, but when error, then you start really to monitor everything. You are taking, okay, why I have this spike, and you are going inside to understand everything. How is APM monitoring? First, we have project, service, website, everything. You can monitor anything here. Then you can extract, APM extracts, collects, actually, metrics. This is like, they call it here, metrics, events, works, traces, MELT. Then this collect information, they put this information that's currently on Datadog Cloud, maybe on Datadog website, probably they host on SoundCloud or some other place. And then from this collected metrics, you can perform some queries, you can observe this data, you can monitor this data, and you can understand the insight from user perspective, root cause analysis based on this data, generate some alerts or anomalies, and tracking individual SQL statements. I'm also a SQL expert, so this is really important for me. I want to see what's happening on the SQL base and level diagnosis, diagnostics too. Lately, we have some issues and we want to understand what's going on with the system. And like metrics, event logs, traces don't help out that much. Sometimes like code level diagnostics is very important to see the profiling. But I'll go this a little bit later. Top APM tools currently on the market, Datadog, New Relic, some others, Traverse, they're almost the same. But currently, our topic is the Datadog. Okay, let's move. Get started with Datadog. First, Datadog is a really modern monitoring and secure, and it helps to monitor and secure your system. Improve performance and user experience, provides all types of monitoring in one place. Like, let's see, you can install Datadog in many servers and only with a single place, a single Datadog website, let's see, you'll be able to monitor this. You can put everything on single dashboard and all information is on one place. This is very important. Like currently for my client, we have like maybe like 30 or 40 servers where we install Datadog and everything is on one place. Some different, we know how to difference the different servers, the data from different servers. And it's really easy to use. Has nearly 400 built-in integration. Has nice documentation. And this includes like integrations are Windows, Azure, SQL, relational databases, Mongo, not relational, Amazon, and so many other things. What is Datadog monitoring actually? I include some basic things because I want to cover, let's see, only them. Infrastructure, servers, networks, again, communication, synthetic checks. Yeah, we have, we are not using Datadog especially for synthetic checks, but these are like ping checks. When you want to see, is your site still online? Is specific API is still online? And you can ping it from specific amount of time. And it's pinged from different location, like not only from Europe, but from, let's see, United States, Asia, and real user monitoring. Everything which you can monitor is actually happening right now. Let's see. Of course, you can change the time, but I'll show you more on the demo part. I want to more focus on the demo, not that much on the information. You can always get this information even from the Datadog documentation. How does this work? Actually, this is very important. Once you understand this, you know almost everything. Like first, we are downloading the agent, or this is we are downloading the Datadog agent. Download in install and configuration and configure it inside our server. Then start automatically after the installation to collect data, traces, logs, events, metrics. What is trace? What are logs? I'll talk a little bit different and we'll show you what I mean this. You are, as we are developers, you develop your application. Don't worry regarding traces and other information. It will be gathered automatically from Datadog from you. And then this information goes to Datadog. And now we are able to create, monitor, and trace this information. You can see nice graphics. Managers are also like those kind of graphics, clients too. And based on these graphics, actually, you are able to observe the key aspects like availability, reliability, scalability, duration. We all pass ticks. We all know that this information is asked, actually. Yeah, it is important really to monitor like availability, is available, reliability, how stable is, scalability, duration, all this information. And now, I'm talking about what do I really use in Datadog? I'm using to configure monitors and alerts. This is one of the most important part because let's to be honest, once you configure everything, you don't need to go every time there. You are going maybe if you have some notification or if you receive some Slack channel alerts or some clients are calling you or QA is complaining for some when you have some failure, then you can go and check and track and easily to notice what's going on. It's save also money and time for managers and also for developers. Like we have some errors on our application. And this is like where to look. Go directly inside Datadog and it will show you where is the erroring, what are the errors, what are the slow queries. So you can immediately understand this. First, when I have some complaints, I'm directly going to Datadog right now. I prepared everything. And I'll talk a little bit later regarding integration. We are using also like PagerDuty integration. If something bad happens, some incident, we directly receive PagerDuty alert from my phone or on actually on Slack channels, so we can immediately react, especially during the holidays. To write an easy and fast query on traces based on this information to monitor server host. Let's see, normally, like when we have a big application, we have some load balancers, we are not monitoring, our application is not only based and host on a single server, it could be host like five servers, and we have Datadog installed on five of them. We are monitoring on, from single location, single website. If some of the host goes idle, some not accessible, I just received another application services. Most of my applications are actually services. Yeah, REST APIs, WCF, WSF, WSMX, different kinds of services. And I'm monitoring this. Service request response error rate, very important. Like it's really nice to know if we receive 1 million calls, how many are there for failing. So this is the error rate or success rate. Service request response latency, very important. SQL queries duration and SLOs, like success rates, I will talk about this. Total request duration and so on. Datadog usage infrastructure installation and integration. I told you that all they are starting with I. It's easy. Okay, what first? I want to explain here the key aspects regarding Datadog. Technical words which are there, technical terms actually which they are using. What is a host? In simple words, this is your server where Datadog agent is installed. Host actually, they describe it like any physical or virtual OS instance that you monitor with Datadog. It could be anything like VM, Kubernetes here, we have example. This is the place where we install our software, actually their software. Like from Datadog. What is Datadog agent? This is the key part. Without Datadog agent, we don't have Datadog. And it's really nice to know what it's doing. So this is the heart of the Datadog. This is the middle layer. Once you install this inside your server, like it's easy installation, you have some application key unique for your environment, for your account actually. You are installing Datadog agent and it's automatically acts like a middle layer between your application and Datadog website and collects metrics and events from your system and application. Once Datadog agent is installed, then your host should appear automatically inside their system, inside the Datadog. And you can go directly in Datadog and see, hey, where is my data? When is my host? Can I see it? Yes, you can see it. It automatically will extract data from your server. What kind of data? We'll talk about. What are Datadog tags? Tags are a way of adding some dimensions, additional information against the Datadog telemetrics. Yeah, so they can be filtered, aggregated, and compared in Datadog visualization. Tags enables you to observe performance across several hosts. I'll show you what they mean here with the Datadog tags. But tags are very important because with the tags, you can make some query search here. Tags can define, let's see, they have some built-in tags like environment, let's see, version. With environment, if I install it, let's see, a Datadog tracer a little bit later, and if I set environment, hey, this server, I want to be environment test. You set this test. For the production servers, we can set this like production, environment production. And then these tags are built-in tags, some system tags like environment and version and service name. These are built-in system tags, so you can make an easy search. They are integrated also already with Datadog, and you can easy filter data using them. You can create your own custom tags too. Every metrics which you extracted from your server also has some system tags and some custom tags too. Let's dive inside a little bit. Main menu options. Now I will show you a little bit like metrics. We'll get you more familiar with the Datadog. Metrics Explorer, Metrics Summary, also dashboards, kind of dashboard, boards and screen boards, everything. Infrastructure, host maps, really important part to list all the hosts, all your servers. Integration, integration, what is integration? Two systems which are totally separate working, interact with each other. And this is provided like Datadog provides some integration. APM services, cases. This is what we are more interested in. And monitors, again, how to configure some monitors. Datadog before, Datadog not. Tracer, I want to do some part of this now. Arthur, Tracer, yeah, .NET Tracer. Datadog agent is a small dog. Once we install .NET Tracer, it becomes a big dog. Now we can make everything, and this will be the enough thing to trace everything, to understand what's going on with our system. Now, what is .NET Tracer? In ATM, a transaction trace give a detailed snapshot of single transaction in your application. Once actually .NET Tracer software is installed in your server, now you are having full access of everything, like what's going in and out from your IIS, all information. It's like all function calls, database call, external calls, and it requires also with configuration some environment variables like environment version and service name. What are custom metrics and tags? Against every, it records every call, let's see, to your system. And this, like every, when the page loads, and you can assign some additional custom tracks from your .NET application into the tracer. This is like custom track, custom metrics and tags. Maybe you don't want to assign anything. It's not obligatory to assign, but let's see, I want, if some page is doing, if some API method is called, I want to see who is calling, right? Username, let's see some agency, some specific data, which is related to my system. That's why I can assign some additional information. And this could be done using the Datadog, like Tracer, ActiveScope, Attack, with K value pair, I can assign let's see, username and my username. Or I can record not only some custom tags, I can record, let's see, custom exceptions, like set exception, using set exception NuGet package. This is provided directly from Datadog NuGet packages. Okay, Datadog trace and demo. Arthur, you can stop recording here so that I'm Datadog traces. I showed you here how to monitor the collected data, how to query service data, how to monitor specific SQL statement, how to perform aggregation here. Now, with Datadog dashboards, now I'll show you Datadog dashboards here. This is taken from the internet. Not, I didn't create the those one. I create similar ones. And now, this one, that dashboard. So, dashboard types for visually tracking, analyzing, and displaying performance metrics here. Yeah, standard definition, it has two types, time boards and screen boards. Time boards are more like specifically depends on the time. You set that time, it is actual for everything inside this dashboard. Screen boards is more for the managers where you can drag and drop different information. So managers, you know, they are logging on the system, opening this dashboard, and they see, okay, error rate is 10%. All good for me. SLO, like this is like something additional which you can set like service layer objective. Let's see, sometimes we want to know how many percent of our requests are good and how many requests are bad. So this is creating time. You are able to create some error rate and success rate. If error rate is under one, then let's see, if success rate is under 99%, let's see, we want to be in green color or in red color, so you can distinguish easily this. Inside the dashboard, you can create widgets. And these widgets are actually here listed, time series, query value, single value, this table, count, I'm showing everything in table and time series, but you can have different options and you can compare them to. Okay. And the Datadog monitors, alerts, and notification. This is like, you can create some, I showed you store procedures, I showed you some calls. On every call, on every sprock, on everything, even on host, you can report, you can monitor and create some alerts and notification. You create this alert, and then if it doesn't fit actually your query, let's see, you receive some notification. And this could be integrated with Slack and PagerDuty. It supports so many integrations, and I will show some of them. Why do we need to set alerts? So this is the core principle actually. Why you want to monitor your system? You need to set alerts. This is like this is the basic of everything. You don't need to monitor 24 hours sitting and monitoring your system. What's going on? With alerts, you can to know before the incident happens. You can understand what's going on with the whole system, how your system is doing, like from the performance management or from the way or from the K metrics like availability, like scalability. Alert types, different alert types, create and update monitor alert, I'll show this, and receive notification from the monitor alert. I will point out the dashboards and and the monitors and alerts how they create the water. Normally, I'm not talking that much. Artem, you can stop again. Let's now get back